Hi guys, my name is Neha Gupta and I am back with the current affairs for October 6, 2020. So in this series of morning tales, I will be discussing around 5 most important current affairs for today. But before moving on to the index for the day, I would like you to subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification so that you can connect with us and whenever we come live on the channel, you get the latest notifications. Now, apart from this, we have a Telegram channel as well where you can ask your queries and enjoy the free quizzes that we provide. So the link of this Telegram channel is mentioned in the description box below. So you can click on that link and join the Telegram channel. Now, here comes the slide on which we will be discussing about the most important current affairs that we are going to discuss in this video. So it is the brief introduction of the topics that we are going to take up in this video. So first we will be discussing about the naval exercise between India and Bangladesh. Then we have UEFA Player of the Year 2019 to 2020 awards. Then a partnership for offering digital payment bank and financing solutions to small retailers. So with which two institutions have partnered here, that we will be discussed. We will be discussing in the third question of this video. Then we will have a NABARD's assistance for Government of India's water sanitization and hygiene, which is short form as WASH program. So what is this WASH program? What is the assistance? We will discuss all these things in the fourth question. Then we have, last but not the least, IIT in Massachusetts Institute of Technology's partnership. What is the purpose of this partnership? That we will be discovering in the last section of this video. So quite a lot of news and interesting as well. So let's begin the session with our first question. But do not budge anywhere because the questions in the last section are very important for you to know. All of the questions mentioned here are quite important from the exam point of view. So here comes our first question, which is about which of the following is the latest bilateral naval exercise conducted by India and Bangladesh in Northern Bay of Bengal. So what is the answer? The options are Indra, Sampriti, Surya Kiran, Aquarian and Bongo Sagar. The most probable answer is Bongo Sagar. If you don't know the answer, if you have guessed the answer, then it is very easy for making a guess that Bongo Sagar could be the latest exercise. Why? Because Bongo is quite synonymous with Bangla. So it's Bangladesh, and Sagar is a Hindi word. That's why we can easily understand that obviously the second country in this exercise would be India. So in this manner, you can easily remember the name of the exercise as well as the countries which are conducting this exercise. So Bongo, Bangla, Sagar is India. From Sagar, you can also remember that this is a naval exercise. Do remember this thing, that Bongo Sagar is the naval exercise, and this year it is the second edition of this exercise, and the first edition was conducted in the year 2019. So that was all that we need to cover in this news. Now guys, I have a question for you. You have to tell me that what are the exercises that India conduct with Bangladesh. Do mention your answers in the comment section below. And here comes our next question of the day, which is, recently Robert Lewandowski has been awarded the UEFA Men's Players of the Year 2019 to 2020. Now you must be thinking that the answer is in the question itself. The statement is directly mentioning that Robert has won this award. Then what is the question all about? The question is asking you about the nationality of Robert. So this is how the question can be twisted so that it can be made more difficult for you. Therefore, you need to pay attention to the minute details. So which country does he belong to? Can you make a guess here? So the answer is Poland. It is Poland from where Robert Lewandowski put up. Now the next thing that we need to cover here is the full form of UEFA. UEFA stands for Union of European Football Association. Therefore, Robert Lewandowski is a footballer. If you remember the UEFA full form, then obviously you can easily remember the profession of Robert as well. So I hope that the question is clear for you and you can now easily remember the answer of this question. And now we will be moving on to our third question. So our third question is, with which bank has Hindustan Unilever Limited partnered to launch a joint project in Mumbai and Bangalore to provide digital payment and financing solutions to small retailers? So the purpose of this partnership is quite clear from this statement: to provide digital payment and financing solutions to retailers of Hindustan Unilever Limited. So retailers and distributors of HUL will get the financing from which bank? Can you guess? So the answer to this question is option E, State Bank of India. From the State Bank of India or SBI, the distributors or retailers of HUL will get a financing of ₹50,000 in order to enhance their business. So this is all about this question. There is no detail detail of this question that you need to mug up. But I have a question for you guys, which is very important. So who is the MD and CEO of State Bank of India? That you have to tell me in the comment section below, because as I have mentioned that this is very important for the examination point of view. And do remember this thing, that this has been launched in Mumbai and Bangalore only, and not in the entire country. So basically retailers and distributors of Mumbai and Bangalore will get this additional facility of ₹50,000 from SBI for enhancing their business, so for digitalizing their business. Now comes our next question, which is the recently NABARD has announced a special refinance facility to support the Government of India's water sanitation and hygiene program in FY21. How much is the total corpus of this facility? So first of all, what is this WASH program of Government of India? The name itself is suggesting that it is for building the basic infrastructure. It is for promoting water sanitization and hygienic facilities in government as well as public infrastructure. So that is why the Government of India has launched this program, WASH program. This has not been launched recently. It has been in place for quite a years now. But recently, for the year FY21, NABARD has extended a total amount of 800 crore. So the answer to this question is ₹800 crore for the government's WASH program. And what will NABARD do with this 800 crore? Under this 800 crore facility, which will be given to banks, RRBs stand for regional rural banks, cooperative banks, NBFCs and microfinance institutions. So these are the agencies which will get the amount from 800 crore, and these agencies will extend loan for this WASH program. So I hope that it is clear to you guys, but in case if you have any kinds of doubts, you can ask me in the comment section below. And that is all that we need to cover in this news. Now guys, you have to tell me that who is the chairman of NABARD too. Remember this thing, that NABARD chairman has been recently, basically in 2020, in the year 2020, has been appointed. So NABARD chairman has been appointed in 2020. And you have to tell me that who is the new chairman of NABARD. And here comes our last question of the day, which is about which IIT, Indian Institute of Technology, has partnered with Massachusetts Institute of Technology to find ways to use industrial and agricultural byproducts. What are byproducts? These are the residues or leftovers of the main products. So in order to put these byproducts of agriculture and industries, Massachusetts Institute of Technology has partnered with IIT Madras. So the answer is option B, IIT Madras, to use these agricultural and industrial byproducts in an efficient manner in order to reduce environmental impact of the agricultural waste, or we can say byproducts. So here we have discussed all the questions of importance for today. I hope that you have liked this session, and if you have really, then do like this video and share it with your friends and subscribe to our channel. Thank you so much. We will be coming tomorrow with the session called flashcards. Now guys, in flashcards we provide the entire month's current affairs in the video. So in flashcard video, September month's current affairs will be provided to you. So do watch tomorrow's video in flashcards, tomorrow's video of flashcard at 6 a.m. Thank you so much.